Hello everyone, my name is SiC and welcome to a playthrough of Anno 1404 running the Venice add-on. This is going to be a pretty long series. I don't know if there's going to be a lot of people interested in this, but I like to play this and I might as well record it while I'm playing it because this game is awesome. It is one of the best city builder games I have ever played. It is very complex later on. Like, it starts off pretty easy and then it just grows in complexity, and then at some point you run out of space and everything just becomes a big puzzle in trying to find out where you can still place a few things, like production buildings to keep your people fed or happy with books or any number of items that they want. And they want a lot. And most of those items in the end, they require several kinds of structures and their own supply system of resources, and things can get quite hectic and complex. And that's good, because scenarios in this game can take up for like 15 hours. For example, when we go to the new scenarios, there is... Let's see, or by the classic scenarios, there is the diplomat scenario. And I finished this one, and it took me 15 hours to complete. It took a long time, but in those 15 hours, I was never bored. I was always busy with something. And at the end of it, I was able to purchase this portrait, which you can use in multiplayer. So I have the Sultan, basically, and I get a diplomat title as well. You can have different titles based on the missions that you've completed or achievements that you've managed to get. For example, the Silent, it comes from an achievement. The Customs Officer comes from an achievement as well. These three come from scenarios or from the campaign, basically. Because the original Anno 1404 had a campaign, or single-player campaign, and didn't have multiplayer. Multiplayer was actually added with Venice. And multiplayer is really cool. Like, I haven't played it in public play, but I played it with my friends, and we can just play that all day long. It's really cool. It's so engaging, and it's such a feel-good game as well. Like, you can play with other people, and they will talk to you, or like other AI people, I mean, and they will talk to you all the time, and that's kind of like a diplomacy thing going on, and they will comment on most of your actions and achievements in the game. It's just a really warm game. It's really cool. So I suggest we get started, and I'm not sure what I want to do at the moment. I think I still have to complete Master Builder, but it's a pretty easy one. I don't know what Guildmaster requires me to do, so let's have a look at that one.
Make your mark as Guildmaster. Carefully nurture your finances to turn your limited starting capital into a huge fortune.
This is probably going to be very challenging and take a long, long, long time. I don't know if there's going to be much of an interest in this game, but I'm going to be playing it anyway, so I might as well record it and hope that some people are following me along, right? So, Guildmaster is used thrift to turn your meager start capital into a huge amount of wealth. We need to accumulate 500,000 gold coins. That's actually not too hard, I think. Obtain an alliance with all the other players simultaneously, that would be okay as well, and then complete 5 quests for the Emperor. You know what? I'm going to go for it. So let's start the game. I don't know, I'm not sure what opponents I'm going to get and how friendly they're going to be, or even what difficulty they're going to be, but probably they're going to be medium difficulty AI characters, which means I need to focus on what I'm doing and get a hurry and basically colonize a lot of islands as soon as possible. Because Anno 1404, if you've never heard of the Anno series before, it's basically a game about an island archipelago, or archipelago, not entirely sure how you pronounce that one, but it's basically a group of islands and you need to colonize them, because each island only produces certain kinds of plants, or it has only maybe you get an island that doesn't have bears on it and you need bears for furs later on, for example, so you need to colonize an island where you can get bears. And there's a whole lot of different kind of things going on like that. But let's set sail and see what's going on. Alright. So we get our one ship.
You can use this ship to find a new homeland. And who knows? Maybe one day you'll even sail it into Oriental waters.
Alright, looks like we have 3 opponents here.
You have
this. Aha! So you want to become a guildmaster.
Well, that's not
that
the island
requires
we need.
Considerable
Let's
financial
go up.
And diplomatic skills.
Alright, so This is one of the first islands I met, and it looks like a small island as well, but up at the top you can see what kind of resources it can produce. And it can produce grapes and it can produce bees, and both of these are late game resources. So this would be an island I do want to get, but not at the beginning of the game. So let's see. Oh, there's an island up here apparently, so let's move up a little bit, see what's up. Or maybe it's just a small... Yeah, I don't think you can actually build on this one. Because usually if you see this much of an island, it will gradually reveal itself, like this island right here. I didn't sail all the way around it, but it revealed all of the things on the island, basically. But yeah, I definitely want to colonize this one, because there's a lot of iron over here.
New island.
Lots of stone as well. There's an island over here. And this one, actually, depending on the size, this one could be okay, because we get cider and hemp, and those are both resources we need in the early game. And by the way, this looks like a pretty massive island, so you know what, I'm going to go for it. I'm going to colonize this island right here. I'm going to set my ship off to this beach, because
you have discovered
this is important as well. Like, you want
island.
To have a big beach so you can discover or so you can build a big harbor, a lot of harbor buildings basically. But I also want some stone in the area of responsibility for the harbor that I'm going to construct in a few seconds. And this is a second tier resource that we need, but yeah, let's see, this looks like a pretty good spot. Or actually, I could maybe get both of those involved, but this looks a little bit better, I guess. Now I'm going to go for both of those things. Need to be careful that both are just in reach. I think like this.
New
right
buildings
there
are ready to be built.
Alright, so we just settled Goldfort on this island, the town of Goldfort, and at the moment we only have the small warehouse and some basic resources, but just a little bit of fish, just 38 tools and 37 wood. So first thing that we probably want to do is we need to see where we're going to build our settlement. For that we need a marketplace where we can construct settler houses, but it has to be connected to our area of influence on the map. So I don't want to build it over here. I want to build it somewhere in this area, so I have room for it, or room to expand. And this looks pretty good. So I'm going to construct this right there, and then we can have some more production over in this area later on with small market buildings, so we can expand on the usage basically, like so. But all the buildings they require upkeep, so we need to be careful and not to expand too much. For example, if you hover over the lumberjack's hut, it takes 50 gold to construct, 2 tools, and 5 gold in upkeep. So that's something that we need to keep in mind as well. And then we have, as you can see, some tiles turn red, because this building cannot produce anything there. So we need to make sure that we have, a proper amount of distance, basically. Let's see, we need to have a little road in between, but maybe... put it up like this. You know what? Up like this, and then connect it up like that. I usually start off with 4 lumberjack huts, because that we need a steady income of wood at the beginning of the game. So let's connect up these things with roads. And let's see, this one needs to be connected up as well. And we need to go up like this as well later on. So I'm going to construct this road to begin with, and then connect this up. And actually my ship needs to do something as well. Let's send our ship south to explore a little bit. And so we have some wood income, that's good. Now we need some houses for people to live in. And of course they also need fish, so we can put in a fishery. Actually, let's put the fishery in first. So the fisherman's hut, we can probably, construct it right next to...
You have discovered another player's island.
Okay. So another guy settled over here, Gold River, belonging to Sir Gavin Langton.
Allow me, Sir Gavin Langton, master in the art of leisure.
Yeah, okay. I think he's a medium difficulty character, so that's okay.
You have discovered a building on an island.
Alright, so we need to construct some peasant houses over here and connect them up with roads as well, because if they don't have roads, they cannot get access to
the
market.
The golden roofs are glittering on the horizon.
Oh, that was quick.
Greetings. I am Al-Zahir.
Right, so this is a very major part of the game. We have reached the Orient. And this is our contact in the Orient, Grand Vizier Al-Zahir. He is our contact here. And we need to build two kinds of settlements. We need to build a European settlement, and we need to build an Oriental settlement. And the Oriental settlement can only be built once we are in favor with the Grand Vizier. And we need to buy a gift over at the merchant, Lord Richard Northborough. There is a splendid gift for a guest, which you can purchase for 50 honor. And at the moment we have 0 honor. So we need to start earning some honor as well. And there's different ways to do that, going to get too ahead of myself. Let's continue with constructing some peasant houses. And I'm going to leave one space alone there. I'm not going to build a peasant house in this space, because I want to use it for something else later on. And it's better to just leave one space vacant for it. Let's see. Uninhabited island. So this is one of the Oriental islands, and it looks really nice as well. But this is not the kind of island that we want. Silk and indigo, we surely do want it, but that's the second tier for the Oriental village or settlement. Roses will be really nice as well at some point. But let's send my ship over in this direction on the minimap. And let's see. Construct this road a little bit. What do they need? They only need food and company for now. And the company is satisfied by the marketplace.
One of my children
and the marketplace, as you can see, has a radius in which it will service buildings. But all of these buildings seem to be connected up by roads as well. And if we get enough peasants, then we can construct more buildings. So probably let's build a few more, actually. We only have one wood left at the moment, so it's a good thing we actually constructed a few lumberjack huts. Because you can see this little guy running around over here with a cart. And this guy is the one that brings all the goods from the lumberjack's huts to the small warehouse. And then we can use it. But the small warehouse only has one of these carts. And if we want to have more, we need to upgrade the warehouse, which we cannot do quite yet. Because what we need to do is we need to go to the second tier of citizens. And we can only go there once the citizens, or the peasants, have everything they need to satisfy them. And in this case, they need food, which is fish. And they need company from the marketplace. And now, at the moment, they need drink. And with drink, they want cider. And later on, we can get beer.
An island has been sighted.
And wine as well. And then later on, we need faith as well. We do need faith right now, actually. So we need to build a church, or a chapel, actually.
It appears that you take good care of your population.
And because our settlement has grown, we now get 50 honor, which is great. Let's see. This would be the town I want to settle, actually. Santa Maria has discovered it, so actually, I want to get a move
you
on and send my ship
a building
up north.
On an island.
So I can get the gift of honor for the Sheikh, and then he can give me a ship with building materials so I can start my second settlement over here.
You have discovered a new
we need
island.
Cider. And I'm not going to put it up to the small warehouse. I'm going to build a small market building. And I want to make sure that this little spot over here is covered, because it's really annoying if there's one spot you can't build on, you know. So we need to connect all of those up as best as we can. And in
you
this warehouse we can
build
some cider farms at. And let's see, where do we want to do it? Probably as far away from there as possible. This looks like a pretty decent spot. Let's see, because you can see this thing turns green if it's still in radius.
Across another player.
And having it in the radius of both of these things would probably be a very good idea.
So, we have finally got to know one another. I am Helena Flores. Pleased to meet you.
Right, so we met Helena Flores, and she is over here by the looks of it, and she's got started on building her settlement as well. But, he as well, of course. But, let's see.
You have
our cider farm now needs
on an island.
Fields to work, or orchards, and we can manually construct them, or we can just press cultivate and it will place these things automatically. But I like to create the fields myself, and you can select exactly where and with what kind of rotation they need to be built to maximize the use of space. So I'm going to connect this up, and probably I'm just going to I'm not going to connect it up to this one quite yet, because it is in range, But I don't want this market cart to walk here and then there and basically forcing myself to wait on these wood or pieces of wood to come in. Right? So one side of farm should do us for now. And then we need a church. And the chapel or the church I'm going to construct right over here, I think. It doesn't cover all of the peasant houses, sadly. But it will have to do. Let's place it down right there. Costing us 12 stone and 5 tools, and we are at 2 wood right now. Or not stone, wood. It required wood. Right? Wood and tools. I think I said stone, right? At the moment we have no ways of making more tools, so what I actually want to do is I want to go to my small warehouse and set up a trade. And we have purchase and selling, but at the moment I don't really have anything to sell. I do want to purchase tools though, and I can set how much I want, and I'm just going to put it all the way up to max. Because I want as many tools as I can possibly get. Alright, so these guys, they now have a chapel, which satisfies their need for faith. And now they're just waiting for cider to come in. And it is slowly being produced, because we can zoom in, you can see this little character basically stomping at the apples with her feet and making cider. One cider has just been made, as you can see, 1 out of 5, which means that now the market cart is coming over to pick it up and return it. And it's going to take some time, but we'll get there eventually. Meanwhile, let's look at the ship at Richard Northborough's place and open up the trade tab here. And then we want to buy the splendid gift for a guest, and probably tools as well for 1540. It's quite expensive if you consider how little money we have, but we do need the tools. Maybe I'm just going to buy 10.
Let's shake on it.
And then I'm going to send this ship over to the Grand Vizier, because I do want to have this island under my control as quickly as possible, because it is huge. It has a lot of things that we need, including a special building where Ismir is doing business, and he does experiments, and he can give us special items that give us special properties, which will be random. I don't know what you never really know what you're going to get.
The Grand Vizier is waiting for you. Al-Zahir is sure to be delighted with this token of your respect and admiration.
All right, cool. But yeah, you never really know what you get. He needs a steady income of resources, though, and I don't know exactly what he needs either. So he could ask for milk and dates, or he could ask for something else. And you just have to give it a steady supply of it to him, and you might get a random item every once in a while. Which is pretty cool, if you ask me. Alright, so right now I'm just waiting for my village to grow a little bit more, and the cider to come in. Let's see, it's 1 out of 5 already again. This guy is still on the way back. Let's have a look. We have 1 ton cider in stock.
Are you trying to assure me of your high regard?
Right, so our ship has arrived and he wants to know if the gift is actually for him. We, of course, say yes.
We are no longer strangers. I hold out my hand to you in the name of friendship.
Right, our ship is going back north.
You have forged the first diplomatic links with the Orient. Splendid!
Alright. So.
This precious ship shall be yours. It is the Sultan's wish.
If you carry on like this, you'll soon be running a metropolis.
My goodness, your settlement! You have a natural talent.
Well, I can slowly allow myself to be seen in your company.
Oh, you asshole. He's such a pompous dick. But yeah, we got a new ship from the Grand Vizier. And you can see it's an Oriental ship. It is called the Topaz. And we have some new building construction or building materials with which we can start a new settlement on this island. And because we just had our first citizens move in as well, We now have more construction options. And now they want fish, they want spices, and spices, they come from the Oriental village. So, we need to get started on that right away. It just arrived, so let's build our first warehouse on the island. Like so.
Alright,
and then...
Ah, Good. Our emperor wishes you to strengthen our relations with the Orient.
Right. If we want to build nomad huts, and we do want to, we need to build a bazaar.
I hope we shall learn much from one another. Inshallah.
Alright, and now we need to decide where I'm going to build my town. And probably, yeah, I'm going to build my town to the coast, or on the coast over here. Let's see. Like so. That's pretty good. Because I want to keep the green area for farming. And that's really important, because you cannot grow any crops on the sand. And to grow any crops, we need, for example, the date plantation. As you can see, everything is red. And we cannot build anything here. But over here, we actually would be able to, as long as we get this into our line of influence, of course. And we need an oriental market building for that. And let's see. There's no special resources up here, but I do kind of want to make use of it as well. So I think placing one building down here would be pretty good. Of course, we need a road to go around this as well. And at this point, we need a date plantation to provide food for these people over here. Let's see. I'm going to build it into this little corner over here. And I'm going to place down my fields manually as well. Because I want to make maximum use of the space that is allotted to me. I want to build everything as close to the unbuildable area as possible, so we have more room to use later on over here. And now we need, of course, some nomad huts with people who can actually eat those dates. Oh, crap. Need to be careful with how you place these. You can do it a little bit too quickly and mess up your design. I'm not entirely sure. I think on this difficulty setting, we get some resources back if we demolish it, but we might only get half. So I don't really know. That's really all we can build at the moment, except for the small Noria. But it takes 30 upkeep, and that's something we need to keep in mind, because right now we're running a deficit of minus 59. So we need to have more citizens who pay taxes. Right, that's what they do. They pay taxes, which you can see up here. They need to be euphoric before they can move on to the next civilization level. But you can slide their happiness up and down, and they will pay more taxes. If I put it up over here, we have them even tempered. They're okay with us, but they pay more taxes, but they're not really very happy. So if I put them at euphoric, they pay 66 taxes. If I put them at even tempered, they pay 101. But I want to keep them euphoric so they can keep upgrading, basically. And the more upgrades we have, the more they will pay as well. But first, we of course need some more houses over here. So, let's see. Let's have another line of houses over here. If they advance, they need, let's see, they need resources as well. So if I can pause it by release, or, yeah, ascension rights are denied right now, which means no building can upgrade.
This. I always knew coming to you.
How much room do we have? 13 out of 19, yeah.
Honor, as always.
Okay. Al-Sahir bought some tools. I think this will be a good time to stop purchasing those.
We'll soon drop anchor in your harbor, inshallah.
And we need to unload the Santa Maria as well. And let's see. Yeah, now you can see these buildings are ready to upgrade. But to do that, they need resources. And you can do this manually as well. And it requires one wood and one tool. So, for example, I can upgrade this right now by clicking this. And I can upgrade that one as well. But it does cost us resources, and I can't really do much without those at the moment. So, let's see. We need to build some more houses if we can. Ideally, in range of the church over here. Yeah, we definitely need more people paying taxes. We are at minus 11 right now. We need to start making a profit soon. So let's go back to the Oriental settlement, because we can have some more people over here as well. Or actually, yeah, in the nomad houses. Let's have another little line. Another five houses there. And yeah, the Topaz is just chilling for now. Let's send him on exploration. And at this point, it would be nice to have a little extra money. So I'm going to go into the diplomacy screen right here, and I'm going to go to Lord Richard Northborough.
My warmest greetings.
And I'm going to ask him for a quest.
I need your assistance with this.
All right. He wants me to deliver 6 tons of hemp at a ship at sea. Alright, and there's going to be a time limit on it as well, like half an hour, in which I have half an hour now to build this. And with the advent of citizens, we can now have more construction options, and we can actually build a hemp plantation, which I'm going to do. So let's build one of those over here. And again, I'm going to place these things manually because I want to make maximum use of my space.
You have discovered corsairs in their hideout.
Ooh. That is less than good.
Bin Said, leader of the corsair and ruler of these waters.
Right, okay, so we met the pirate faction, and they will be a nuisance. They can be paid to be peaceful, or you can destroy all of their ships, but it's going to require some combat, and that's, I don't know, it's less than ideal. Unless you have a strong navy, but a strong navy requires a lot of upkeep, you know, so that's kind of hard. Anyway, we have our first hemp plantation. It has 20 upkeep, which is kind of harsh. But we have no real choice. Actually, we do need two of them. So let's see. We need three spaces or three tiles to have room for a field. So let's build one right there. And we can build one of these things over here. We can have one in the middle like this. I guess one like that. And another one like that. And then we have four out
of
four.
You have discovered another player's island.
Build a small road, of course. And I'm going to leave them to make some hemp first, so we can complete our quest. And if we do that, we will get 50 honor and one custom goods, linen garments. Okay, so you can get a levy from trading. And if we trade more than 15 tons of goods, we get 5 tons of linen garments for free. But no actual money. That's a little bit sad. So we need to be a little bit careful with what we construct from now on. We need to make sure that we have enough people to actually, release the ascension rites again so people can keep upgrading themselves.
Your building opportunities have been expanded.
Alright, Ashabat has grown. So now we have some more building options as well, and these people now want milk.
You know
which we can give them.
How to lead a settlement to success.
Yeah, a goat farm. 20 upkeep,
Another
we have 60 income at the moment,
an
and it requires
settlement.
200 to build. Yeah, we can do that for now. We can do it, it's fine. Let's see. How do I want to place this? Probably over here somewhere, but we need some space to place down the goat pens. So, let's see. One in the back there, one next
you
to
have
it.
Discovered a building on
one
a
over
night.
There. It needs
Another
three
player
to be
has built an oriental
fully successful.
Settled.
Yeah. Right? Where? Oh, he's down over here somewhere. Alright, not sure if it was a big building or a big island or not, but we'll see, we'll find out eventually. And by the looks of it, we don't have any more wood coming in, so we need
you
to build
a... across another player.
Let's see, two lumberjacks huts over here as well. And these do work, but they're very, very slow.
I'm so pleased to meet you.
Ah,
a friendship for keeps, my heart with joy leaps.
I'm going to build two of those, because we do need the extra wood coming in. Leif Jorgensen is actually an easy player. Not sure where he is actually. Oatsville. Oh, he's over here. This is his settlement. He's quite big already as well. Interesting. Okay. Let's see. We are at 21 of 22, so we have some more. One more house can get upgraded. But what do they need?
Exactly
they need garments. Yeah, how is that looking? We need, let's see. We don't have any hemp coming in yet. Of course, these fields do take some time to grow. They are fully matured now, and we have people working in them. If you pay attention, you can see right there the people are working. And let's see, 1 out of 5 produced, 3 out of 5. Let's go for an instant pickup. Which you can use, like a market cart is coming, now we have 2, but you can only use this every 3 minutes. And that's the same over here, you can only use it once on the island, every 3 minutes. And that's a lot of work. Alright, last thing you can do with the honor as well, there is the attainment system down here, which is the flashing button. And you can purchase upgrades, for example, if I get the Emperor's Trade Edict, we can then purchase citizen goods at the warehouse of Lord Northborough. same treasures of the Occident is citizen items. Or we can have the Imperial Merchant Fleet, which enlarges the Imperial Trading Fleet with one ship and slightly increases each ship's trade budget. Because he has ships that will go around the map, as well as the Grand Vizier. The Grand Vizier has ships that go around for trade as well. And they will buy stuff from you, or they will sell stuff from you. Or they will buy things that I sell, or they will sell things to me. That's what I wanted to say. Let's see, can we get... Yeah, it's 3 so far. We need 6. And let's see, there's a ship. Ah, it is right here, yeah. Yeah, if you haven't really noticed yet, these graphics look amazing. Like, you can see the reflection on the water and the refraction of the light and things on the bottom there. It is a gorgeous, gorgeous game. And actually, if you press F1, you can go into postcard view. Like this. And you can get a little... you can get very close up to your people and take screenshots like this. Like I said, it's a postcard view, so you can make screenshots like postcards and things, and it's pretty sweet. Right, do we have only 3 out of 3 so far? He has 3, okay. So we should have enough in a few seconds to complete our quest. There we go. And then we can send our ship to its objective zone. There we go. Alright, so what's up next? We have more construction options now, which is good. We need to build an ore mine, but to do that we need bricks or stone. And to get that we need a stonemason's hut. And we had a stonemason's hut, or an option to build one over here, and one over here as well. I'm going to build one up here because we already have a road. And let's turn it around so it looks pretty sweet. Want to turn it around like this, and it's just in between these zones of the woodcutter's huts, which is great. So now these guys are starting to cut down the rocks, and we can get some stone coming in. We do need more tools though, and I don't have the money to buy it, so we are in a little bit of trouble, because the quest that we can do, there is a timer on it of half an hour, so we can only do this in the next episode, basically. And the same is true for all of these. Because the Grand Vizier can give you quests as well. But if you get a quest from one guy, you cannot get it from the other anymore. And in this screen, actually, you can talk to the other people as well. So you can talk to Helena Flores.
I was just thinking about you.
And you can propose a trade treaty, so you can buy goods from each other. But you need to be friendly with them. We need to be at a peace treaty. Right now, we're neutral. And to get more reputation, you can upgrade your city, or things like that. You can grow bigger and bigger, settle new islands and things. Or you can, intimidation, you lose reputation. So if you want to go to war with them, you can intimidate them into declaring war. Or you can ingratiate, and that will give you extra reputation if it works out. Because there's a probability of success of 75% at the moment. So let's give that one a try.
That's exactly what I think. A noble title alone does not make one better than others.
Yep, that gave us +4 reputation, so that brings us a little bit closer.
Helena we can Flores do the same. Is a beautiful flower amongst withered weeds, just waiting to be plucked by a gentle hand. And my hands are very gentle. And
what can I tell the Emperor about the quest?
Dude. That guy is so annoying.
Thank you.
And not this guy, but
you
the other
done
one.
The Empire Sir Gavin Langton. Service.
How kind of you!
See, now I get one reputation as well, because I helped out somebody with a quest. And they really like that. So we can do, we can ingratiate ourselves with all the other ones as well. So let's go to Leif Jorgensen.
And you chose to come to me? Are you sure?
And he's a little bit easier to ingratiate, because he's an easy character and he's very insecure about himself.
Since you ask so nicely, I'd be delighted to recite my poem. The day it wakes to dawn at last, signaling that night is past.
Alright, and finally Sir Gavin Langton as well.
Almost didn't recognize you. A hero, you say? I think that's it.
Alright, and finally you can talk to Hassan Ben Sahib as well.
My ships are already on the lookout for you.
Well, we cannot offer... Yeah, we could offer a trade treaty, but he's going to decline it because he has no respect for us. Alright, a new island has been discovered. Ooh! This island is very nice. Hemp, grain, and grapes. So this will be a pretty good expansion for us. And it also has some iron over here, some stone. And it's pretty damn big too. Wow. Yeah, I want to expand there, I think. And I want to expand over here as well. But we actually, honey, I've never really had much of a use for so far, because it's very, very late game. This might be our first priority, actually. Let's see, what else do I want to do? We're making some money, but we definitely need to start selling some stuff as well. Let's get a weaver's hut, because we do need to have all this hemp be made into something. Let's place one down, and now we can start making some linen over here, or some linen garments. And that's something that people need to be happier. And once they get this, they will start paying more taxes as well, which means that our tax rate goes up, and we can get some more money coming in. But I really wish that we had a quest that would give us some money instead of like this item over here. Because for the moment, we're not going to trade 15 tons of goods anytime soon, I don't think. But we're going to put it in the warehouse anyway. It has maximum 3 slots that you can place things in. But at the moment, we only have the 1 slot because it's still a small warehouse. Alright, is there anything that we can do for trade? Because I do need some money. Not really. We could actually use another cider farm as well. You know what? I'm going to get the 6 hemp. And I'm going to bring it over to Kingsport and try to sell it. It's not going to give us a whole lot of money, but I need everything I can get at this point. And at the moment, yeah, let's build a few more houses as well. Like so. Connect them up with a road. And I think we've been going on for quite long enough at this point. So I'm going to sell the hemp and then I'm going to end this episode. Because we've been going at this for a while now. I think we've probably reached the 45 minutes mark at this time. And that's quite long, so yeah, it's pretty much time to end it soon. I do want to have the Imperial Merchant Fleet to have more trading ships coming in. So I'm going to get that one, and then I'm going to use the last bit of honor that I have to get another gift for the Sheik. So our ship is almost there. Yeah, look at all the small detail, like all of the people have such fluid animations, and there's so many different kinds of people walking around and doing different kinds of things. It's really, really cool.
The doors of my storehouses are always open to you.
144 gold. Okay, that's almost nothing.
Feel free to.
Okay. And let's get a splendid gift for a guest.
You've got a good deal there.
And then I'm going to send him over to
Sheik. I accept this trade.
And that is going to be it for this episode. So please like and subscribe if you enjoyed this and want to see more. And I'll see you guys for the next video.